Good evening and welcome to the Thursday, April 13th, 2017 meeting of the Northampton School Committee. I'm Mayor David Narkowitz, and I will begin the meeting by asking the clerk to call the roll of the school committee.
Ms. Holly Vernon?
Here.
Ms. Rebecca Bezanski?
Present.
Ms. Present.
Ms. Anthony?
Present.
Ms. Meyer?
Present.
Ms. Moore?
Here.
Ms. Jeanette
Reed? Present.
Ms.
Present.
Ms. Jelani Crawford?
Here.
And Mayor David Narkowitz?
Present.
Your honor, you have a pen.
Thank you, and I'll just note for the record that about 5 minutes ago, Mr. Kaufman was just elected and sworn in as our newest member representing Ward 6, so congratulations and welcome to you as our newest colleague.
You're quite welcome. Thank you very much.
Okay. So we are actually not starting with public comment this evening. We have, sorry about that, Julie. We've got some special VIP.
Don't waste any time.
No problem.
Kids.
We've got some special VIP guests that are here. In honor of the Week of the Young Child, I know Barbara Black is here, and she has a number of children that are with her, and I think, and some moms, that we're going to
Barbara, come back.
Issue a special proclamation in honor of this special week. So I don't know, do you want me to come to the podium?
Barbara, I'm not
to the front. Okay. Okay.
You don't live in Ward 6, you couldn't.
Kids, yay! Yeah.
All right, so we are here. Are we all here?
Yeah.
Almost.
Everybody came?
It's one more.
Hey, so the mayor's going to read a proclamation. It means like a speech. And then we're gonna, give them some things.
Okay.
Okay. So we have much company tonight. But we could, you could proclaim, and then we'll introduce.
Okay. Thank you very much. So,
thank you.
So, actually, as Barbara told my staff, where we actually have two versions of the proclamation. We have the boring one and the fun one. And I've been instructed I'm supposed to read the fun one.
Yeah, yay!
So, but I'll be giving you both the boring one and then the fun one. So this is called Hooray, Go Wild for the Week of the Young Child, with apologies and gratitude to Dr. Seuss, April 24th through the 28th, 2017. Whereas one child, two child, red child, blue child. Whereas this one is a little wild, that one is a little mild, but wild, mild, or in leaf piles, we celebrate the week of the young child. Whereas there are some that like to run for fun in the warm spring sun. And what in spring could be more fun than celebrating young children? Whereas early years are the learning years, where we can encourage hopes, not fears, praise parents, teachers, caregivers with cheers for supporting our future chefs and engineers. Whereas from here to there, brain building is happening everywhere. And so now, therefore, I, Mayor David J. Narkowitz, do hereby proclaim, last week is gone, last week was fun, this week is yet another one. This week is one to go hog wild and celebrate the week of the young child. In witness whereof, I have set my hand and affixed the seal of the city of Northampton, David J. Narkowitz, mayor. So happy week of the young child to all.
Okay, so let's see. Oh, that's the podium, I guess.
Yeah.
You know what? On the chair where my backpack is, there's some things we have to give out. There's some paper, and there's some magnets, and there's some, all kinds of things. Okay, so, are you guys able to do that? To give things to the people sitting in the chairs up there? Okay, so, and you can, they can shake hands with you if they want, but they don't. So, everyone gets one of these packages. Few people, some of these. Okay. Whoops. Okay. All right. Here we go. Here's three piles of these, and then everybody. Everybody gets one of these. Let's see. We have some of these are magnets, and some of these are just cards. So let's just divide these. Okay, everyone gets one of these. You want to take some? And who else needs some? Do you need some? Does somebody else need some?
Yes, thank you.
Okay, and then is there anyone else that needs something to give? Because I have one more.
Magnets here.
Yeah, okay, so we have magnets. Here's some magnets. And is there somebody else?
Scared me.
Okay, is that everybody? No, you didn't give anybody else? Okay, all right, so. Okay, so what we're giving all of you is information on the Week of the Young Child Festival, which is not going to be till the 29th. And it will be, you know, it will be our usual wild event. We'll go hog wild. We will have lots of big vehicles. It's sort of a monster truck for preschool. And we'll have lots of activities. And it's free. And we're hoping that many families will join us. And we also are giving you information about the Brain Building in Progress campaign, which is basically what we all know, that what happens is kids learn a lot when they're very little, and all of us are involved in helping them learn. And so this is about thinking about all the ways that we are building kids' brains when we're in the grocery store, when we're walking down the street, when we're in the car, when we're on the bus, when we're folding the laundry, all of those things. And it's just a reminder that everything that parents and teachers and other grown-ups are doing with kids are ways that kids are learning. And who we have with us tonight, we have so many people, I don't think I can introduce everybody, but we have a whole bunch of people from Jackson Street, and then we have a preschooler from Leeds, we have a preschooler from Bridge, and we have a kindergartner from Bridge. So we have, I don't know, kindergarten, first grade, second grade, do we have fourth grade? We have a lot.
Fifth grade.
Fifth grade now?
You got a fifth grader there.
Oh my gosh.
And we have fourth. And we have
fourth. Yeah, so we have all of our grades represented here. And I want to thank everybody for coming. This was lovely.
Father, do you want them to pass them out to the counselors?
Yes. Sure. Yeah, did you
go? Will you lead them down the tables? You just go down the table and give each person
one thing.
Don't bite.
Thank you. Well, sometimes I do.
Breaking
I'm mad.
Your fourth wall.
I'm sorry.
Shake your head.
Speak for yourself.
Thank you.
Oh, thanks.
Thank you.
This is great.
What grade are you in? Yeah. Is your teacher this year?
See this?
Everything.
Are you a twin?
Was a very interesting life.
It's like that is the year.
Really?
One of those. Thanks very much.
Saturday. I don't even know what day it is. It's so funny.
Just log in.
Bring it out of
yep. No NPS.
Thank you very much.
Would you be willing to give these to you?
Oh, thank you.
Do you want to give those to her?
Thanks.
Thank you.
Share them afterwards,
too.
Out
thank
tonight.
You.
Anybody else need anything?
I am. You know her.
You
in her class.
What's your name?
I just handed them to a student.
Thank you.
They're on the podium.
Okay, great. All right. Now, we'll let people take them home with them. That will be great. So we'll give those out. So every family should take home a proclamation. Okay? All right. And I thought that in honor of brain building, the superintendent and I are being twins wearing brain building in progress t-shirts.
Yeah.
Just so we can, you know, make the point. I don't always wear this t-shirt.
Neither does he.
I think we don't usually. But anyway, it just seems
certainly not together.
You know, just that point of that we are all doing this together to raise our kids. So thank you, and thank you for all the work you do to support everybody who works with kids.
That's the password.
Thank you. Thank you, Barbara.
Yeah.
Thank you, children.
You're so funny. It's making me remember. I think it's NPS OC and then learning.
Don't count on it.
Yeah. You should go first.
No, I learned. I remember the password. Just remember the username. Does that sound great?
Stay.
Okay.
So cute.
So now, that's the superintendent, Mr. Rogers.
I know, it's true.
Wow. It's fast.
Okay, so now we move on. So now we will resume the back to the agenda. We are now on item number 3, which is our public comment period. We would ask the folks who wish to speak in public comment to please state their name and address for the record, and if possible, to please limit their remarks to 3 minutes. And I see that Ms. Spencer Robinson is at the podium, and I'll turn it over to you.
It's a tough act to follow.
Yeah.
Children and a dog. Yeah. And Barbara Black, a legend in her own time. My name is Julie Spencer Robinson. I live at 248 Spring Grove Avenue in Florence, and I'm the president of the Northampton Association of School Employees. I am delighted to see on tonight's agenda the ratification vote on the 6 contracts the association bargained collaboratively with the school committee. My members have been waiting a long time for this to happen, since January 10th, to be exact, when we voted to ratify all 6 contracts. I'd like to remind you that 25 of us spent 70 hours in negotiations to reach these tentative agreements. And I want to express my appreciation on behalf of the NACE bargaining team members to Downey Meyer, Molly Burnham, Howard Moore, and John Provost for their dedication to a grueling, rewarding, and very productive interest-based bargaining process. I hope that you view the outcome of our labors favorably tonight.
Thank you very much. The next person signed up to speak is Jeremy Whalen.
Hi, everybody. Jeremy Whalen, 214. I think they're having a lot of fun out there. 214 Pomeroy Lane, Amherst, Massachusetts. I'm also a technology teacher at Northampton High School. And I was just in the neighborhood. But I just wanted to, say thank you to Dr. Provost and all of those who stood out with us today for outside of Northampton High School. I think that politics aside, we as educators have a duty to welcome everyone in our classroom and to give the same education and access to all of our students too. So to be with us in that symbol of unity, it meant a lot to myself and our school. I also want to congratulate the transcript and Elena Fragamini. They had 3 New England Regional Student Emmy nominations this year. So we went from starting our news broadcast to 3 regional Emmy nominations. So it was an incredible honor for them. And Elena was actually one of the individuals that received one of those nominations. And the last thing, I thank anybody that sits in a room for me for 70 hours. And so contract negotiations, I think that it was a very collaborative process. It was a bunch of people in a room from both sides of the aisle, but came to a mutual understanding that we put our district first, we put our students first, and the due diligence that both the school committee and NACE came to an amicable decision-making process was a really, I appreciated that process. So thank you all.
Thank you, Jeremy. The next speaker signed up is Garrett Adams.
I feel called upon to stand up once again tonight. My name's Garrett Adams, and I'm at 148 Crescent Street, Northampton. I'm a teacher of English as a second language at Jackson Street School and Bridge Street School, former kindergarten teacher and former preschool teacher at Clark School for the Deaf in the integrated preschool program. I came tonight to thank you and hopefully to make you feel proud to voting to ratify the new contract between the Northampton School District and the Northampton Association of School Employees. The contract was jointly and thoughtfully negotiated in common interest over many long sessions over more than a year with strong unified resolve to provide equity. It's an example to other districts and a way in which we in Northampton are leading Massachusetts and leading the country. We're a wall-to-wall association that represents cafeteria workers, custodians, educational support professionals, teachers, and many others, now administrators as well. There was a lot of work that went into making the language and benefits as similar and equitable as possible throughout the contract, and most importantly was to raise the floor for our lowest paid employees. Our budget direction undermines some of that work, and you know my feelings about that, and I hope that we can move to continue to modify. But the second point, which I'd like to address tonight, has to do with the job that I do, teaching English as a second language to students who are learning English as a second language at the same time that they're learning everything else that everyone else is learning. These students are part of our general education program. They're not part of a substantially separate program. They're just a specific case of differentiation, and they have civil rights that are specifically guaranteed. The guidance for our department has been updated by the Department of Education three times in the last 18 months or so as a direct result of civil rights clarifications that are completely in line with our direction of full inclusion. That is, access to the same curriculum and activities as all other students. Tonight you'll be hearing about and perhaps making decisions about a candidate or candidates for the position that will supervise all student services. Because there's a zero in the budget line item for ESL administrator, this will include my students who are learning English. The person informing and advocating for these students' needs and rights and accountable for them really should be someone who has training in teaching English as a second language and experience working with English learners. This is an administrative position, and the decisions, communication, actions taken or not taken have a great influence on general education, and it really relates to everything. So someone asked me this morning, I said, I look like a priest. I said, you're close, I'm mourning a loss. We found out yesterday the people that we're losing in our elementary schools and our students are losing next year, not just the positions. I hope that we can work to build up from our strength. In Barbara Black and those children, you saw the strength of our district. We're a strong district. Let's build it.
Thank you.
Thank you, Garrett. So those are the names of the folks who had signed up to speak tonight. Is there anyone else who wishes to speak in public comment tonight? Okay, seeing none, we'll now move into the recommended actions portion of the agenda. We have...
Are we going to do announcements?
Oh, my apologies. Announcements. I'm sorry. Ms. Musansky.
I just wanted to let folks know that Tuesday, April 25th is the Massachusetts Association of School Committee Day on the Hill, and myself and Ms. Burnham and Ms. Frogamini and maybe Ms. Fallon will be going, and anyone else who would like to join us, but either way, we will certainly bring back what we learn from that day. So,
Ms. Fallon.
As the liaison to the Northampton Prevention Coalition, I just wanted to ask Northampton parents and guardians of students in grades 6 through 12 to please check your mailboxes today for the survey reminder postcard, and follow the link to participate and enter to win a $100 gift card from Visa or to the Hampshire YMCA. Your input's essential in helping the Northampton Prevention Coalition to plan our substance use prevention and education programs. An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. So give us 5 minutes, and the link to the survey will be found on the postcard. If you don't receive a postcard, you can also look for the Northampton Prevention Coalition on Facebook, and there's a link to the survey on that as well.
Ms. Hennessy.
The evaluation of the superintendent, as you guys know, is an ongoing process, but at the end of the year we have a subcommittee that does a report, and just to let everyone on the committee know and the community know that if anyone has any feedback, to please send it all to Mr. Zuchowski.
Or me. either in writing or certainly phone calls or face-to-face.
Any other announcements? Okay, so now we'll move into item 5, recommended actions. We have a consent agenda tonight that includes the approval of the minutes of special school committee meeting December 12, 2016, and the superintendent evaluation team meeting of April 6, 2017. We also have four field trip requests. We've got the NHS track teams track invitational at Regis College in Weston, Mass, May 6, 2017. We have the NHS outing club north of Highland Camping Area in Truro, Mass, June 2nd through the 4th, 2017. We have the JFK 6th grade going to the Connecticut Science Center in Hartford, Connecticut, teams attending June 9th, June 13th, and June 16th of 2017. And then we have the Ryan Road 5th grade going to the Connecticut Science Center, Hartford, Connecticut, on June 16th, 2017. And I would entertain a motion to approve the consent agenda.
Motion to approve the consent agenda.
Is there a second?
Second.
Okay. All those in favor of approving the consent agenda, please say aye.
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 Opposed? Any objection? Any abstentions?
I abstain.
Okay. So there's one abstention. Otherwise, the consent agenda is approved. Next item on the agenda are reports and recommendations, and we'll begin with a report from our student representative.
Hi, everyone. So I want to start off by congratulating the Northampton High School Theater Department on their amazing production of the Spring Musical. This happened in March, but I was unable to attend the March meeting, so I hope you all had a chance to see it, but if not, there are many more ways to support the NHS Theater Department. You can find those out by liking the Friends of NHS Theater Facebook page. It's just a great way to support the theater department, which so many kids at Northampton High participate in, and we want to continue that arts education and programs at our high school. I also want to congratulate a few student groups on recent awards, and Jeremy kind of stole my thunder a little bit, but this is a bit of a long list. So the Teen Advocacy Group of Northampton High recently earned a Certificate of Achievement through the Whole Picture Film Contest for their short film on the intersection of mental illness and substance abuse. So Stephen Andrews, Claire Chung, Julia Snodgrass, Corinne Carratt, Scarlett Sands Bliss, Calvin Calhoun, Luna Everhale.
Would a custodian please call the pool office? Custodian, please call the pool office. Thank you.
Nell Sanders, Olivia Pruitt, and Cassidy Armstrong have been awarded finalists in the 2016 Western Massachusetts Whole Picture Film Contest, which celebrates filmmakers who use critical thinking and holistic reflection to explore important issues while educating others. So if any of you get a chance to see that, I believe you can find it on the Whole Picture Film Contest website. As Jeremy mentioned, the transcript received 3 New England Student Emmy nominations in the categories of High School Broadcast, High School Serious News, and High School Talent. And the Northampton High School indoor track relay team of Nick Smith, Ben Gordon Sniffen, Patrick Quinlan, and Cole LaValle received All-American status at the New Balance Indoor Nationals this spring. So congratulations to all of those students who were awarded, and there are so many more students at Northampton High who do amazing things. So congratulations to them as well. Students at NHS recently went through the course selection process for next school year, and I just want to take a moment to thank NHS teachers and faculty for the wide variety of course offerings they provide students. NHS students have the option to take new courses such as women's studies and social entrepreneurship. I also want to thank the NHS History Department for really listening to student and community concerns and advice in their work to diversify the history curriculum. The NHS History Department offers elective courses such as Black History, Women's Studies, Sociology, History of the Holocaust and Modern Genocide, and History of the Islamic World. Women's Studies and History of the Islamic World are 2 new courses this year, and it's just really fantastic at their efforts to diversify that education and move it away from that Western-centric view, and they're wonderful courses. Students are really enjoying them, so thank you to all the teachers who are working on that. And that's it.
Thank you very much for your report. The next item on the agenda is a proposed vote on our district value statement, which we have discussed at several prior meetings and has had some additional work done on it, and I will turn it over to the superintendent.
Thank you very much. Really just tweaking the wording of the 3 values that were presented a few months ago when we presented the results of the district-wide QSORT. Before I read it, I guess I'll just offer one observation. I remember a conversation with a school committee member once who wanted to know whether there was a form of accountability for school committee members that went beyond just vote, you know, the idea that if you're not doing a good job, someone else will take your place and the voters will let you know. I think this is an opportunity for the school committee and the district as a whole to have a set of norms to hold each other accountable to. So I will just read them for the sake of those who don't have the packet. The district value statement says the following values were drawn from students, staff, and parents of the Northampton Public Schools. They reflect what we believe to be truly important to our community. Build communities of engaged students. Students make meaningful connections when they play a contributing role in their schools and in the larger community. Enable students to reach their potential. Students thrive academically and individually when they are given opportunities to be active participants in the learning process. Nurture kindness, empathy, and tolerance. Students learn best when they feel supported and respected and understand how they can support others. And I'd just like to thank Ms. Bizanski and Ms. Burnham for helping with final tweaks to get this to a state where we hope everyone can get behind the values.
Okay. So do we want to have a motion to put it on the table for discussion, if, in case there's any discussion?
I'd like to make a motion to put it on the table for discussion for approval.
Ms. Fallon, would you like to second? Okay, great. So the value statement has been moved and seconded. I'll open it up for any comments or discussions about it before we take a vote. Did you want to discuss the
changes,
tweaks you made, or the changes?
Sure. I think at our last, when we last discussed the value statements, there were some comments, most specifically, I think, about the second one, about enabling students to reach their potential. And so Ms. Burnham and I sort of worked to kind of align it better with the results of the QSORT. We and the results from what came out of the community meetings as well. And this is where we landed. And then in the third one, we kind of fleshed out it was a little shorter, I can't remember the wording right now, but fleshed it out a little more, nurture kindness, empathy, and tolerance. And in the first bullet point, we struggled a lot, and the superintendent was very helpful in helping us kind of flesh out what does it mean to be an engaged student, that before it didn't really read as though, anyway, we wanted to sort of flesh that out a little bit, because an engaged student could be many different things. I also want to thank Ms. Fragamini for her input, and the superintendent also ran this by the alt team, so we got their input and approval as well. So I think it's been just part of the process to, as we've gone along from the beginning of the QSORT, to get everybody's sort of everyone on board. So hopefully, yeah. I think we're there. I think.
And thank you. And just to add to this, that I think that we really were trying to do something and to craft statements that were student-centered, but put an equal responsibility on all of us as community members, as educators, and students, that we're all part of this education, this thing called school, and that we didn't want it to be one. And we do start each sentence with students, because that is the center point of our communities, but that we hoped that we were expressing them in ways that said that as adults, we are the facilitators of this, and these are guiding principles for us to follow.
Any other comments or questions?
I have a couple.
Oh, certainly, Mr. Moore.
So I think I agree with the values of this statement itself, but I think another thing to remember is the important value of the process. I think the whole QSORT process and the discussion of what that meant was really very valuable, and really important to sort of use as, if not an exact model, but as sort of the idea for a lot of the things we do, if we can apply the similar sort of idea of, you know, figuring out how to draw from a lot of people and engage a lot of people in the base in an appropriate and responsible sort of way, I think we can really benefit a great deal. So that regardless of what the particular thing is, so not necessarily saying we need to do the value statement over and over again, but all the other sorts of decisions we make, that having a formalized institutional sort of process leading up to something, a product in the end, can be really very beneficial.
Yes, Ms. Bisansky.
I just wanted to add one more thing, which is in this kind of process of rewriting or tweaking them, I went back to the Northampton Public School mission statement, and it was kind of a pleasure to see how well these two align, and that the results of the QSORT could have, I guess, could have come out differently. But in fact, you know, we heard from our community that the mission statement that we have really matches and dovetails quite nicely with the value statement. And so that was sort of, there was something reassuring to that, that maybe we're sort of on the right track with our mission statement, and this is a good way to express it.
Okay. Any other questions or comments? Hearing none, I'll ask for a vote to approve this value statement.
Second
all
that.
Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Any abstentions? Okay, so that's been approved. And again, thank you to the superintendent and to the members who've worked to bring that forward and finalize it for us. Next is a vote on a proposed letter to the editor on choosing your child's school. This is an excellent letter that our colleague, Mr. Reed, has put together, and it's being brought to you tonight for review and hopefully approval so that it can be, I believe, sent to local newspaper. So I'll turn the floor over to you.
Okay, thanks. Just to clarify a little bit, sort of the background of what this came from, the idea is this would be an op-ed from the school committee, and it came out of the survey that Mark Watts did about why people were choosing charter schools over our schools, and the desire to, you know, one of the things that we struggle with is putting out our own message and explaining to to parents what's great about the Northampton Public Schools. I mean, I think we're all aware of it because we're kind of going behind the scenes and seeing what's happening in classrooms, but I don't think that always gets out to the public. So the idea was to kind of use the bully pulpit of the entire school committee saying, hey, parents, when you're trying to make this decision about where to send your kids this spring, here are some questions to think about, and here are some thoughts about what we're doing in our schools. And so the process was that Dr. Provost asked the principals to suggest questions, and we kind of blended the questions that the principals put forward with the sort of the goals that were in Mark Watts's survey, and then the principals helped us provide the background to some of the answers to these questions. So that was the process, and that's all I have to say. I hope.
Okay. So, any questions or comments about the proposed guest column, I think, or op-ed guest column? Yes, Mr. Moore.
I did have one. It's just as when I read it the first time, and I don't know if this is an appropriate place to adjust it, but I just, when I read it, and then I read the opening paragraph, and then I was reading the questions, I went back and had to reread the opening paragraph because it sort of felt like the questions and answers, at least the first few, were specifically geared towards elementary school only. And I had sort of been expecting, because of the introductory paragraph, to have something under that first question about maybe the high school and the middle school, and I didn't see it. And so it just threw me off a little bit in terms of what I felt I'd been primed for and what I got. And I understand, you know, it's it might be hard to write differently, but that was my only editorial comment.
I can just explain the thinking behind that was that Mark Watts was pretty clear in his survey results that the deciding point happens mostly before elementary school, then a little bit in middle school. So that's
and that's why I was thinking maybe the first paragraph would be where the change would take place to prime you to know that those were what the questions and answers were mostly going to be about. I just felt a little bit like I was looking for something that I wasn't there. Not, and because of what I'd been primed for in the opening paragraph, and I don't know.
So you're referring to where it says where to send their children for elementary school, middle school, and beyond.
Yes, exactly.
So,
and I don't know, again, but I understand also that is also a true, fine topic sentence. I'm not, you know. It's just that if I felt a little bit then awash as I was reading the rest. Anyhow, I got my grounding by the time I got to the end.
Okay, that's good. Yes, Ms. Musansky.
I agree with what Howard said about, I kind of got confused because it seems like it's really, the first paragraph set me up to think it was about all three levels of schools, but it sounded to me like it was really written mostly for elementary school. But what I'm most confused about is if we're trying to put this out so that parents because parents are making decision between Northampton Public School or charter schools, all the charter school decisions have been made. Or, I mean, at least Hilltown, Chinese Immersion, PVPA, so I think our timing is a little off. Hilltown made their decisions in February. PVPA's decisions have been made at least a month ago. And Chinese Immersion, I think their last lottery was like a couple, they've had three lotteries, so I don't know. The last one was a few days ago. So I just think our timing, we're just a little bit too late, that I'm worried about that it's not going to have the desired effect. And I wonder if the title shouldn't be more about, like, why choose Northampton Public Schools, right? Are we trying to really put out a guide to whether to choose charter schools or public schools? Or are we trying to put out a statement on why we think it's important to choose Northampton Public Schools? And then just my last point is I feel like, you know, some of our greatest strengths as a public school district is that the points about being a neighborhood school, that we have diversity, and that is sort of the great equalizer. And I just feel like those are important points to include in here. Those are really, to me, they're really compelling reasons to choose your neighborhood public school. So
I've been speaking to Mr. Reed about this for quite some time. And so I think in our conversation, Mr. Reed was always kind of saying, the sooner we can put something together, the better. And he's been saying that to me for quite some time. So I guess in his defense, what I would say is I agree. I think it is a little late getting out there. But at the same time, the message, whether it's for this year or next year, or school choice, or a reconsideration of a student that may have been accepted somewhere else, to have that information and those questions out there. And I don't think it's a one-time type of editorial that we can put out into the newspaper. It can be something that we can look to try to do annually or as often as we see fit as far as that part of getting the information out. So I guess I'm only speaking to the timeliness of it. It was something that we've been trying to work towards and put together for quite some time, understanding that we were kind of under the gun to try to get it out to reach those students that may be making choices or have already made choices.
So, Ms. Bargamini.
I love hearing all your comments, and that's great. In terms of like a little bit of a different topic, I really loved when I was reading this, hearing about everything that was going on in all of the schools and all the after school programs and science projects that kids are working on, the genius hour, I had no idea that was a thing. So I almost wonder if there could be like a separate editorial as we go into like September. I don't know if you guys do this, that's like what to take advantage of at your school, and here's everything that Northampton Public Schools offers, because parents coming into the district or new parents probably don't know that they have a genius hour. I've been in the schools for a while and I didn't. So just another idea for the future, because that was what I really gained from reading this.
Just respond to that. I thought we were just going to do an up or down vote on this.
Yeah.
I know it's going to be a long night. But anyhow, there are people who have been trying really hard to get good information about what's happening in the schools in the paper, and all I can say is that it's been a struggle.
I get that.
So, Ms. Fallon.
I'm sorry.
I didn't see you.
Mine was just a quick thing.
Sure.
Can we just use the American English spelling of cozy instead of the British English spelling of cozy? It really threw me off. That's all.
It's a level of...
Okay.
Ms. Burnham. Yeah. I super appreciate the work, but I guess it is sort of true. Like, I feel like like the genius hour is actually only at one school right now. And I kind of get, you know, and then one school is mentioned in, you know, Bridge Street School is mentioned in one, partners with Historic Northampton. So sort of like there is a crafting element to it that I understand if we want to get it out, that's fine. But I feel like it does feel a little uneven And I don't want to misrepresent, you know, I don't want somebody to come to a school and like, well, I thought you guys had genius hour. And you're like, well, actually the other school has genius hour or something. You know, I don't know. I get a little worried because I do feel like we are held to a higher accountability than a lot of other things.
Okay. So. Sure. Yes.
So, thank you. I just read this. I just to set the stage. I might abstain very often tonight, and it's just because I don't know what I'm voting on. I don't endorse field trips, but I don't know what our role is. It's not that I object to these things. I did because of the conversation. Thankfully, had an opportunity to read it, and I think it's very well written, and I totally endorse it, and will vote for it. I will just say that I like the way you set it up in such a way that it's not competitive with charter schools. It's just trying to build up the positive kind of programs that we have here. But that said, if I'm working in a charter school, an advocate for a charter school, and I see this in the paper, I'm going to respond, and we need to be aware of the fact that somebody will respond and say, beautiful job by Northampton Schools. This is the kind of questions that everybody asks, whether it's a traditional school or a charter school. We offer this as well. And in addition, we also offer these things. So there might be some animosity, or there might be a reaction to this that might not be what we want. If what we want is the parents to look at this and go, aha, ask these questions when you go to Northampton schools. The little I know of charter schools, I think they offer these same things as well, many of them, and some will say they offer above and beyond. So it's debatable if we're going to get what we want out of it if what we want is the parents to choose Northampton schools. So I just think we need to be ready for that, but I endorse how it's written. I appreciate how it's written. It's high quality, and I do, like I said, I don't like it being look what we offer as opposed to. I think it really helps parents make some effective questions when they come to the schools.
Do you have a comment, Mr. Meyer?
No,
he does not. Okay. So I think the intent was to bring it for an up or down vote, not for us to try to wordsmith it, but I did want to just get people's comments and questions about it. So what would people like to do? Would you like to make a motion so that we could put it on the floor?
Sure. I'll make a motion to
it's number C.
Are we making a motion to authorize the letter to be sent to
I believe what the request is, yes.
So I'll make a motion that the letter to the editor on choosing your child's school presented this evening be endorsed so that we can send it to
the Daily Hampshire
to the Daily Hampshire Gazette.
Second.
Okay. Any further discussion about that? All those in favor, please say aye.
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 Those opposed? Any abstention?
No.
There's 1 no. 2 noes. Okay.
3 noes.
3 noes. Okay. Any abstentions? Okay. So the motion carries. Next item on the agenda is a resolution of support for the rights of Northampton students, regardless of their immigration status. And to this, I'll turn to our colleague, Ms. Burnham.
So I've been crafting for some time a resolution of support. The superintendent was kind enough to dedicate some time at our meeting 1 to 2 times ago or something. Talking about what we do in Northampton to protect all students. And I see this as an opportunity to rededicate ourselves and just say it very formally, what we stand by and what protects our student under both Massachusetts laws and federal laws, as well as our non-discriminatory enrollment procedures, and also the practice that we follow if an ICE employee or an INC employee were to come to the schools. This is a number of other school committees have also taken up resolutions like this, and I researched those. I feel that what I'm bringing forward is just a commitment of our school committee to say that these are the protections that are in place and this is what we stand by.
So,
do we want to have a discussion?
Sure. Would you like to make a motion?
I would make
to,
a motion
to
have to approve this.
Okay. There's a second. There's a second. Would it be helpful?
Should I read it out loud?
Yeah. Why don't we have you read it out loud, just okay. For the record?
Okay. A resolution of support for the rights of Northampton students, regardless of their immigration status. Northampton Public Schools are committed to educating all students, regardless of their immigration status. With this in mind, we reaffirm our dedication to and support of the rights of these students under both the Massachusetts state laws and federal laws listed below. The Massachusetts Student Anti-Discrimination Act provides that no person may be excluded from a public school in any town or discriminated against with respect to obtaining the advantages, privileges, and courses of study of such public schools on the basis of race, color, sex, gender, identity, religion, national origin, or sexual orientation, MGLC 76-5. I don't know how to read that simple, sorry. The Massachusetts anti-bullying law prohibits, among other things, bullying by students or school staff on school grounds or at school activities, MGL C71-370. Title IV of the Civil Rights Act of 1964 prohibits discrimination on the basis of race, color, religion, sex, or national origin by public elementary and secondary schools, 42 U.S.C. 2000C et sec. Title VI of the Civil Rights Act of 1964 prohibits discrimination on the basis of race, color, or national origin in any program or activity receiving federal financial assistance, 42 U.S.C. 2000D. The Equal Educational Opportunities Act of 1974 requires, among other things, that schools provide English language learners with appropriate services to overcome language barriers that impede equal participation in instructional programs, 20 U.S.C. 1701, and then Plyer versus Doe, 457 U.S. 202. In addition, Northampton Public School District practices a non-discriminatory enrollment procedure, as well as having an existing district policy that requires all visitors to state the reason for their visit and be cleared for entry into a space with students. Consistent with that practice, any immigration and naturalization service, INS, employee intending to enter any Northampton public property must first notify the superintendent and the district's general counsel of its intention in person, with adequate notice and copies of a warrant signed by a judge or magistrate, so the superintendent and general counsel can take steps to provide for the emotional and physical safety of its students and staff. I would add that some of this did, our Attorney General Healy had written up a statement, which I was able to also use, and I collaborated with the superintendent on the last paragraph.
I'd like to offer,
Mr. Moore,
I'd like to offer what I would think is a technical amendment to enter any Northampton public school property, insert school there.
So just a.
So instead of Northampton.
No, just adding school because.
Public school property?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I would need a second for that amendment.
I'll second that.
Sure. So there's been a motion made and seconded just to make an amendment to add school after Northampton Public in the final paragraph. All in favor of the amendment, please say aye.
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 Opposed? Any abstentions? Okay, so we're back to the main motion as amended. Any other?
Mr. Meyer. INS doesn't exist anymore,
so we should probably amend it.
That's, yeah. I raised that
yeah.
to the superintendent, but he had sent it to our legal counsel. I said the same thing, and they never got back to
yeah,
us about changing it.
It 2003, so
that's what I thought.
CBP and ICE are the two.
That's what I thought. Okay.
So do you want to make?
To amend from Immigration and Naturalization Service employee to employee of U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement or U.S. Customs and Border Protection. I guess it would probably mostly ICE.
So I think you're covered because I would assume borders underneath ICE. I
think.
They're separate. So there's three. Yeah. So, I mean, you can just say, if you want to use the umbrella.
Yeah, even border patrol agents in Northampton.
You never. I've been stopped in Vermont.
Yeah.
So I should put ICE.
Yeah.
You are in agreement.
I would
with that.
Yeah. But yeah. Immigration and Customs Enforcement.
Yeah.
Most likely.
So you're making that motion.
I'll second that.
Okay.
A petty thing, under the Massachusetts anti-bullying law, the very last number, you said 370. It just looks like it's really actually a big O and not a zero.
Oh, thanks.
To change it. And my second is a question. So consistent with that practice, any ICE employee or whomever intending to enter any Northampton public school property must first notify. That's according to whom?
Yeah, do you want to answer?
Sure. That's according to the directives we've given administrators, saying that if someone who appears to be an agent of ICE appears at the door, ask for the warrant, and then just have them wait in the office and call me so that we can get legal counsel.
So are they, this might be too much, are they, so I guess two things. One, is this front staff trained in that? And number two, would they say that, or would they just say, I'm here to see the principal? And would someone come up and say, I'm here to see the principal? Because I'm...
Well, I mean, we actually don't know, because it currently is not their policy to enter schools,
okay,
or houses of worship, or hospitals. So it's all hypothetical to that extent. But what the directive I've given principals to train their office staff is, in the event, they should ask the agent to come into the principal's office and then call me immediately so that we can contact our attorney,
okay,
and figure out the next best steps.
Thank you.
Okay, so...
an amendment on the table.
Yeah, I understand. People were adding additional pieces to it. So before we took another vote, I wanted to. So, Mr. Meyer, will you accept
the
friendly amendment of Ms. Hennessy to your amendment, or just addition to your amendment?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So there's been a motion made to amend. Is there a second?
Okay.
Seconded? Okay. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 Ms. Judd, are you keeping up? Do you have everything? Okay, I just didn't want to go on until I made sure you had everything. Okay, so any other questions on back to the main motion, Ms. Fallon?
So I'm allowed to ask just a general question?
Sure.
Okay. I'm just curious where this is going to appear. Will this be in written form? Will this be on the website? Is this just a statement we're putting out and then it disappears? I didn't know if it was going in the student handbook next year, or if it was going on the website next week, or what the plan was if it were to pass tonight.
We actually didn't discuss notification on this. The handbooks have already been amended with similar language that I think is apropos to the handbooks. This is sort of more a general statement of the, I guess, just the legal principles regarding enrollment of students. I think appropriate place would be in our registrar's office and other places where students come to enroll, or in other places where enrollment information is distributed.
And you will have it translated into the various languages?
Can I add on to
sure.
That? I think it would be really great if also it was given to the schools, to the faculty and and principals. One of the things that I feel about this topic is that people had a lot of questions about it, and I feel we'll continue to have more questions about it, and this is a document that are the people in the schools can draw from to help when people ask it at their schools.
Okay, so we're on the main motion. It's been amended, made and seconded now on the final resolution. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Any abstentions? Okay. Great. Okay.
Nice job, Molly. Thank you.
Yes. So the next item on the agenda is a report from the Rules and Policy Subcommittee, and I'll turn it over to Ms. Fallon, who's going to discuss several second reading and votes that we need to make this evening, as well as a couple of first readings on some policy changes.
Yeah. So the first The first policy we'll be discussing is policy JECB. This is a revision of the policy, and it is a second reading, and we'll be voting on it. Since it's short, I will read it as it's been revised. Foreign students who wish to attend the Northampton Public Schools must be enrolled in a recognized foreign exchange program or reside in Northampton. Those students enrolled in a recognized foreign exchange program must reside with host families in Northampton. No special services will be provided to students enrolled in recognized foreign exchange programs. And it's cross-referenced to policies JF and JFABB. And we, JFABB is a new policy that we'll be voting on next.
Okay. Is there a second?
Second.
Okay, so there's a motion made and seconded to adopt this revised policy. Any discussion or questions about it? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Any abstentions? Okay. You can proceed. And,
the next is actually a new policy, policy JFABB. It's also a second reading, so we will be voting on it tonight. It's the acceptance of international and exchange students. This policy details the acceptance of international exchange students. It defines F1 and J1 non-immigrant student visas. It explains the tuition payments and timeline and the procedures to be followed for both F1 and J1 exchange students, with the hope that we will begin accepting those at the high school in 2018-19 school year. And as I said, this was a new policy that's been created, and it's cross-referenced to policy JF and policy JECB.
Would you like to make a motion?
Yeah, move to adopt policy JFABB.
Second. So there's been a motion made and seconded. Any discussions or questions about this policy? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Any abstentions?
Abstain.
No abstention. Mr. Coffin. The next item on the agenda is a first reading on a
Yeah, so this is these are two related policies. This next one is a first reading. Is it all right if I take them in the opposite order?
Sure.
It makes more sense if we address policy IJNDD first, social media and electronic communications. So both these policies, IJNDC, which is new, and policy IJNDD, social media and electronic communications, are intended to address the concerns that staff had with the policy IJNDD, which said all staff websites will be Google sites within the Northampton K-12 domain. And that's, in fact, the only language that's changed on this policy, IJNDD. It says all staff websites must comply with school committee policy IJNDC, which is the new policy we created. That's why I asked to take it out of order. The two policies were meant to strike a balance between protecting student protection and student access by creating a protocol for vetting and identifying websites beyond the Northampton K-12 domain, which teachers can use. And so the new proposed policy, IJNDC, will direct the digital literacy computer science coordinator, Ms. Molly McLaughlin, to maintain a list of vendors and applications that are acceptable for teachers' use. So this first reading, it's a first reading, but this policy IJNDD, all it's doing is saying that instead of staff websites needing to be Google within the Northampton K-12 domain, all staff websites must comply with school committee policy IJNDC. So then we created policy IJNDC, which is school and district web pages. This is a new policy, and it is pretty much what I just summarized for you, but it talks about how the use of third-party systems for the creation, maintenance, or support of Northampton Public Schools websites, unless they're an approved vendor, is prohibited. And so Ms. McLaughlin's responsible for keeping a list and updating it as teachers request or as new applications come on the market. And so it was meant to protect students, but also allow teachers more options.
Okay. So this is a first reading, so there's no vote required tonight. Are there any questions that people have about them at this first reading stage, or any concerns about the policy just between now and second reading? Okay. So this will come back to you at your next meeting as a second reading. So does that complete the report of the rules and policy subcommittee?
It does.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Fallon. Next, we'll move back to the next item on the agenda. This is a required vote to accept a gift of property. This is Smith College. It's 4 Eaton Rack UPS units that will be given to the Northampton Public Schools. I'll have Ms.
Yes, this is a very generous gift from Smith College. It's actually from the Clark Science Center. As you see on your paperwork, it has an estimated value of about $20,000. And what it will do is let us replace some outdated UPS uninterrupted power supplies that we have for our networking system to put us in a better situation in case of power failures on any of our equipment. This being a property gift, we'll need to go to the City Council for acceptance, too, under our policies and school committee, City Council policies. Anything over $10,000 property value also requires a City Council acceptance.
Make a motion to accept the gift from Smith College, the 4 Eaton Rack UPS units to Northampton Public Schools.
Second. Okay. Any discussion or questions?
I have a question.
Yes.
I can't remember now. This all gets vetted before it comes to us. Like, this went through. Okay.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Just wanted to make sure.
Mr. Pagan.
Yeah, because I didn't know if, when the timing up was it, but I knew we were in a transition.
Yep. Okay, any other questions? There's been a motion made and seconded. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 Opposed? Any abstentions? Okay, so that gift is gratefully accepted. We'll bring it over to the City Council, hopefully their next meeting, to get that started for the approval process. The next item is a vote. This is a gift from the JFK PTO in the amount of $1,500 for the Connecticut Science Center field trip.
Yes, your school committee policy allows a principal to accept gifts directly from the PTO themselves with a value of up to $1,000. So this one at $1,500 exceeds that. So this is a $1,500 donation to underwrite the cost of the sixth grade field trip to the Connecticut Science Center.
Make a motion to accept the gift from JFK PTO in the amount of $1,500 for the Connecticut Science Center field trip.
Second.
Is there a second? Okay. Any questions or discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Opposed? Any abstentions? Okay, so that gift is also gratefully accepted. Next, we'll turn to the business administrator for both her business administrator report and the personnel report.
Yep. So you've got your monthly expenditure report here. We're actually into the last quarter of the year, so this is the, as far as I'm concerned and my office is concerned, we are heading into the year-end close already. We are actually in the process right now of doing a more in-depth analysis of the budget to project exactly where we will be by the end of the year as we head into the end of the heating season and start winding down the school days with subs and the other related expenses. So we'll have more detail for you probably by next month in terms of the overall picture. We know things continue to be tight, particularly in the special ed department. Are there any specific questions on the report? Okay. An update for you on the advanced placement exams. We had mentioned in the past that the federal government had pulled the funding that they previously had directed to the College Board that actually subsidized the cost of all AP exams for free and reduced eligible students. The good news recently, because we talked about this through our budget process and the mayor has been able to recruit some donations for next year, fortunately to get us through this year, the state received a donation from the STEM Council that will underwrite about two-thirds of the cost of the AP exams for students taking AP exams in the STEM fields. So there still will most likely be some costs to our budget this year, but it will be substantially less than the $5,000 that we had projected would be our cost this year. So it's a one-year situation, and hopefully the federal government will be working with the state to come up with some grants next year. So we may not have to rely on the donation, but we've got the donation hopefully as a backup for us. And lastly, we have the gifts that have been accepted in the past month in accordance with your policy.
So from PTO gifts that were accepted by the principal, we had four, all at JFK, in addition to the one that we spoke about earlier tonight. It was a $500 donation to underwrite the Great East Band Festival. It was a $655 donation of various gifts for Spanish trips and award programs, a number of things that added up to that $600. It was a $500 donation for the Grade 6 Pen Pal Meet and Greet Program. All of those contributions will be deposited into the student activity accounts where they've already got existing funds for those programs. And the last donation, the PTO will pay directly for. It's a $400 donation for the Grade 7 Dance Performance Assembly. And gifts accepted directly by the superintendent. There were three this month. The first two were at the high school. There was an anonymous gift of $1,000 to apply towards the boys' lacrosse transportation. And there was a gift from Tim Barnes and Night Owl Tattoo of 15 Sunpak tripods for some cameras and smartphones in Jeremy Whelan's program. And the last one was at JFK Middle School. There was a gift of library books with a value of approximately $450 by Esther Cole. She actually works for the JFK Presidential Library, and she does a fundraiser each year by a sponsored SWIN program, and then the money is then used to buy books for the library program. And on the personnel report. Predominantly at this time of the year, it's turnover in substitutes, subs coming and going. We do have, we had a new nurse hired, one nurse who had resigned, and we've replaced her, and then a number of part-time support positions in the district.
Thank you very much for those reports. Next, we'll turn to the superintendent for the superintendent's report, Dr. Provost.
Thank you. Tonight's report has three parts. The last part, I feel like both of our candidates were sort of tapping into the same thing that I'm tapping into, so some of it may sound like you've heard it before, because you have. First, I'll start with a couple of celebrations and recognitions. Our athletic director, Kara Dupree, has obtained national certification as an athletic director. She just got an award for that. That's a great achievement for her. Also, connecting to the first item on tonight's agenda, Northampton has been identified as one of the six CFCE networks to be honored this month at the State House in their annual Brain Building Partnership. So it's a great honor, I think, for Barbara Black, and a great way for her to kick off her final Brain Building Week. I'm saying that. Next, a few items in the area of management and operations. Having passed the budget at the committee level, we posted the anticipated vacancies for the 30 new ESP positions created in the ModWINS design. We received 34 voluntary transfer requests from current ESPs, and we were able to honor 20 of those requests, thus filling two-thirds of the new positions via voluntary transfers. Based on the current positions we have filled with long-term subs and known retirements, we believe that there will be 39 positions in all that need to be filled. So in the end, we'll have 20 voluntary transfers and 19 involuntary transfers. Happy to report that we achieved our goal of completing the reorganization without laying off any ESPs. Not to diminish the disruption to our ESP unit when about a third of the members will find themselves in new positions next year. This is something that the leadership team is very sensitive to, and will be taking into account as they welcome ESPs into new roles within their buildings or to new buildings. At the same time, I'm really pleased that we were not in the position of having to deprive any family of income and benefits that it depends upon as part of this reorganization. Also, tomorrow is the deadline for school choice applications. We anticipate opening about 40 choice seats for the upcoming year. The majority of those will be in grades 9 and kindergarten. We will be conducting the lottery the week after April vacation to provide families and schools with information they need to plan for the fall. Anybody wishing to have a student participate in the lottery must have their school choice application to our office by the close of business tomorrow. Also, MCAS 2.0 online assessment has begun in grades 4 and 8. It seems that the work that we have done to upgrade our technology infrastructure and increase bandwidth is paying off in the form of trouble-free assessment experiences. The one problem I heard was not related to anything we did, but for a student who hit the submit button before he was ready to submit. But the technology didn't fail. Not long ago, I have to tell you that the thought of 400 local users simultaneously logging on to the same website would have caused our knees to buckle. But things have been smooth thanks to the efforts of our new DLCS working in concert with the city CIO. So far, we've been using Ethernet-connected devices for the testing, but we plan to use some Chromebooks for the upcoming sessions in math so that we can ensure that our Wi-Fi network can support additional users. This is the only real difficult part of the testing process has been ordering tests. The process that's been created for principals is really cumbersome. Essentially, it comes down to a principal creating a unique order for each student to ensure that they have the right accommodations and doing it all through a website that is a little glitchy. So I also want to thank the principals for the long hours that went into tediously ordering tests for every single student. So next I'll move on to some thoughts that are related more to leadership than to management. Trying to look a little farther down the road with eyes higher on the horizon, I think our focus still needs to be on the high needs future. A great deal of attention has been paid in a lot of the reports that I've shared with the committee to outcome measures, but we haven't talked a lot about predictive measures. Many of you will know that the Department of Education provides a predictive tool known as the Early Warning Indicator System, or EWIS. The EWIS assesses the risk of a child not achieving developmental milestones for their grade level group, and it's a mathematical model. In the modeling, students are identified either as low, moderate, or high risk. 90% of the students in the low risk group are predicted to achieve the developmental milestones by the expected age. 60% in the moderate group are expected to achieve their milestones, and just 20% of students in the high risk group are expected to reach their milestones. So for us, looking down the road really means looking at the incoming first graders. Really, you'd say incoming kindergartners, but there is no EWIS indicator for kindergarten, so first grade is the first look we have to look at our students. And it's really interesting indicator because it's one that's based almost purely on student demographics. The only school-related variables in the model at first grade were attendance and kindergarten. So it's really just based on the types of risk that we know are associated with learning difficulties present in our group. So 2 years ago, 37% of our first graders were in the low risk group and only 20% were considered high risk. In our current first grade, 38% of our students are in the high risk and only 7% are considered to be low risk students. So that's a tremendous change in just 3 years. So I don't want to sound like a broken record, but I think it bears repeating that the population we're serving and will be serving in the future is changing. And this is the reason why we're changing the way we use district resources. I agree that, you know, as has been said at this table, the time to have done this would have been long ago, or the time to have begun planning it would have been long ago, but the change is here. And our students, and so we're trying to address that. This all connects with some of the anti-bias training that we're doing in the district. We recently had a training by Usman Power Green, and he referenced a book called Immunity to Change, which a lot of our administrators are now reading. You know, usually you think of immunity as a good thing, but if your environment is changing, immunity to change can be dangerous to you. So a spontaneous book study is sort of breaking out around our administrators on the book. And I think it's really important for us as we think about change, because a lot of the questions we're hearing have to do with sort of technical changes involved with implementing inclusion. And one of the themes of the book is you have to go a level deeper. You know, don't think about how you're going to rearrange process. think about what you have to change in the way teachers can perceive their roles. So we're developing that sort of as a focus of our work with teachers, although we do hear that teachers still want to have the PD at the technical level. I think the leadership challenge for us is really trying to support them through change on the adaptive level. And it is a developmental process, and I think it's important for us to say to all that it's a developmental process. In the first year we do this, we're not going to be as sophisticated or as comfortable as we'll feel in the second and third and fourth and so on. But it's a journey that we're starting together, and it's a journey that I think we will find takes us to a place that is very good and that at the whole district can be very proud of. So that's my report.
Thank you, Dr. Provost. So now we move on to item 7, we need to entertain a motion for an executive session.
Make a motion, request for an executive session in the JFK Principal's Conference Room under Massachusetts General Open Meeting Law, Chapter 38, Section 21A2, conduct contract negotiations with personnel, student services director, superintendent, business administrator, and Chapter 38, Section 21A3, to discuss with respect to collective bargaining NACE. Oh, there's more. Whereas an open session would have a detrimental effect on the school committee's negotiating position.
Okay, so there's been a motion to move into executive session. Could I have a second, please?
Second.
Okay, so on this, I'll ask for a roll call vote, please. And the response is either yes or no to move into to executive session.
Ms. Rebecca?
Yes.
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 Yes. So I need to announce to the public that we will be moving into executive session because to discuss these various issues in open session would be detrimental to our negotiating or bargaining position. I also need to announce that we will be returning to open session to take votes. So we will be moving into an executive session now, but we will be coming back into an open session for votes. So we are now. Good evening. This is the Thursday, April 13th, 2017 meeting of the Northampton School Committee. We are reconvening an open session after having been in an executive session. And we do have some new business items that we will be taking up in open session. The first is to make an appointment of a new Director of Student Services, and I will turn it over to Dr. Provost.
I'm happy to announce that my good colleague, Dr. Pam Plummer, will be the new Director of Student Services for the Northampton Public Schools.
So, in order to make that official, I'd like to request a motion to appoint Dr. Plummer to be our new Director of Student Services.
Okay, I'd make a motion to appoint the Director of Student Services, Dr. Pam Plummer.
Second.
Okay. Any discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Any abstentions?
Yes.
One abstention. Okay, so congratulations, Dr. Plummer, and enjoy your time away and rest up and get ready for the new challenge. So, thank you. Okay, the next item on the agenda is a vote on a contract renewal for our superintendent of public schools. And we are pleased to announce that we have reached agreement on a renewed contract for Dr. Provost for a new 5-year contract with the district. And so I would ask for a motion to approve a renewed contract for Dr. John Provost.
Make a motion to approve a new contract for Superintendent Dr. Provost.
Second. Okay. Any discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? Any abstentions? Okay, congratulations. The next item on the agenda is a ratification of the 2016 through 2019 collective bargaining agreements with NACE. And I will turn it over to Mr. Meyer, the chair of our bargaining unit. And he will be actually seeking votes for ratification on individual bargaining units, because we do have a couple of cases where members will be abstaining from certain bargaining units. So we're going to take them not as a group, but take them individually. So I'll turn it over to Mr. Meyer.
Yep. I'm going to move ratification of the agreement between the Northampton Association of School Employees Teachers Unit and the Northampton School Committee. This is covering the period July 1st, 2016 through June 30th, 2019.
Is there a second?
Second.
Okay. All those in favor, please say aye. Sorry.
Do you need to recuse?
I can abstain.
Well, you really should recuse. So, I mean,
sure.
Generally, even the presence of the member is considered participation. And
okay. So we may want to just have you step away from this. Sorry.
It's getting old.
Our new member. Sorry. Okay, so there's been a motion made and seconded. And again, we've had one of our members who stepped away because of a family relationship to one of the bargaining unit members. So all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Opposed? Any abstentions? Okay, so that is ratified. Thank you.
Okay. The next agreement is between the Northampton Association of School Employees Educational Support Professionals Unit and the Northampton School Committee, covering the period July 1st, 2016 through June 30th, 2019. So I would move ratification of that contract.
Second.
Okay. So, and this is the ESP contract?
Yes.
Okay, great. Excellent. Just making sure. Okay. All those in favor of ratifying the contract, please say aye.
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 Opposed? Any abstentions? Okay, it is unanimously ratified.
Next one is the clerical unit. So this is an agreement between the Northampton Association of School Employees Clerical Unit and the Northampton School Committee, covering the period July 1st, 2016 through June 30th, 2019. I would move ratification of this agreement.
Myself.
Second.
Okay, so there's been a motion made and seconded, and I would just note that Mr. Zahowski is recusing himself from this vote because of a family member that's a member of the unit. Okay, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Any abstentions? Okay, that is unanimously ratified.
Okay, the next is an agreement between the Northampton Association of School Employees Custodians Unit and the Northampton School Committee, covering the period July 1st, 2016 through June 30th, 2019. I would move ratification of this agreement.
Second.
Okay. Any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Any abstentions? Okay, so that is unanimously ratified.
Okay, next is the agreement between the Northampton Association of School Employees Administrators Unit and the Northampton School Committee, covering the period July 1st, 2016 through June 30th, 2019. I move a ratification of this agreement.
Second.
Okay, there's been a motion made and seconded. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? Any abstentions? Okay, that is unanimously ratified.
And saving the best for last, the agreement between the Northampton Association of School Employees Cafeteria Workers Unit and the Northampton School Committee, covering the period July 1st, 2016 through June 30th, 2019, I would move ratification of this agreement.
Second.
Okay, there's been a motion made and seconded to ratify the cafeteria workers agreement. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 Opposed? Any abstentions? The contract is unanimously ratified, yes. And all of the contracts with NACE are ratified. So congratulations to all. Okay, so future business and meeting dates. We have a Rules and Policy Subcommittee meeting on May 4th, 2017 at 3:30 p.m. in the City Hall Hearing Room. And then we have a regular school committee meeting on May 11th, 2017 at 7:15 p.m. in the JFK Community Room.
Motion to adjourn.
Okay. There's been a motion made, seconded, which is a non-debatable motion. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Any abstentions? Okay. So the meeting of the Northampton School Committee is adjourned.